Hello, hi students. A very warm welcome to yet another marketing class. In today's class, I will discuss about product and brand personification. Now, product or brand personality is created when people attribute human traits to products or brands. It creates a positive sentiment an emotional attachment with the products of the brand, of a particular brand. So a distinct brand image creates a distinct personality of the brand, which sets it apart from other similar offerings. All right. Now, brand personality can be either functional or symbolic. When we say functional, we say based on performance, like for example BMW, they say it's a performance driven brand, it's driven by performance. Alright, so that means the brand is dependable, it is a rugged, strong brand. But whenever Nike says that a brand which targets the athlete in all of us, it doesn't mean that we have to be athletic to wear Nike stuff or Nike merchandise or something like that. It simply triggers or stimulates the sportsmanship, the emotion of sportsmanship inside us. So all of us can wear and enjoy. Alright. So now all these brand personality gives an image to a brand which creates a positive purchase intention in the consumer's mind. Customers think about these brands in a positive manner. The moment you say Johnson & Johnson, everybody knows that it is a skincare, hair care product for babies, for infants. All the mothers, they feel emotional. All the everybody feels emotional because long back when they were infants, they were small children, their mothers used it, baby shampoos, baby powder and all these things. So Johnson & Johnson has positioned itself in that fashion. The moment you take the name, small babies come to your mind. Their skincare, hair care, no more tears, shampoo, everything comes to your mind, you know. Everything comes so lively and memories come rushing towards your mind and all. So it is a very important thing for the companies, for the brands, to create an image or to be able to successfully position themselves so that their name is on the tip of the tongue of their consumers. So for this, they have to attach their brands with emotions of the consumer so that the consumer becomes loyal to that brand and the purchase intention increases in the minds of the consumer. So a few examples of strong brand personality are, number one, you can say Raymond. Raymond is a company which says, okay, a complete man. Raymond creates a complete man, a man who is successful professionally, personally, and also a very caring father, a caring son. So it takes or carries both the aspects of a person, the strong professional type, the successful professional type, as well as the caring son or caring husband or father type. Then similarly, you can have Zodiac, example of Zodiac also. Even they say corporate executive. So Zodiac with its apparels brand, with its apparels and products of corporate merchandise and all, it created a brand image of corporate executive. So you can think of being an official or a very high ranked official when you go and buy Zodiac stuff. So this is the emotion which is being attached by the marketers. Then coming down to the very good example of Lux. Lux is very contemporary oriented. Every time you can see celebs are raving about Lux soaps and Lux body care stuff, body care products. Because Lux is triggering the glamour element of the consumer. So you feel that glamorous if you are using Lux. So in that same fashion, all these brands are personalized, personification is happening, and they have their distinct brand personality which sets them apart from other similar offerings in the market. So with that, it's a wrap, students. See you in the next video with a different topic. Thank you so much.